In this lesson, in chapter 3, sharks, let us discuss about design of sharks on the basis of rigidity. Objectives of this lesson. On completion of this lesson, you will be able to understand the designing of sharks on the basis of torsional rigidity and lateral rigidity. The factors needed to be considered for the above rigidity conditions. What is torsional rigidity? The resistance against deformation under the action of shear force. The force acting tangential to the resisting surface is called rigidity. The angle of twist example here is the angle of twist for circular shafts, that is torsional deflection. Design of shafts based on torsional rigidity. The angle of twist or torsional deflection theta in radius may be obtained by using the relation, that is torsional equation T by J, FS by R, J theta by L. If you want to design the shafts based on strength, yeah, you have taken two parameters, that is T by J is equal to FS by R. Now it is the design based on rigidity, that's why T by J is equal to G theta by L. So theta is equal to T L by G J, where T is equal to torque on shafts in Newton millimeters, and then J is equal to polar moment of inertia, mm power to the 4, G is equal to modulus of rigidity, and theta is equal to angle of deflection in radians. L is equal to length of the shafts. For solid shafts, the value of T and J can be found from the equation. P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. That means T can be torque, twisting moment can be calculated by using the power formula. And then J is equal to pi d power to the 4 by 32. There is the polar moment of inertia, whereas the moment of inertia is pi by 64 d power to the 4. Here it is the polar moment of inertia. That's why it is pi d power to the 4 by 32. And where P is equal to power transmitted by the shaft in kilowatts, and N is the speed of the shaft in revolutions per minute, and D is equal to diameter of the shafts in millimeters, and T is the torque in kilonewton meters. For hollow shafts, and the value of T and J can be found from the equation, and T can be calculated from the power equation, and the J can be, that is polar moment of inertia, is equal to pi by 32 d power to the 4 minus small d power to the 4 by d, where capital D, T is equal to power transmitted by the shafts in kilowatts, and N is equal to speed in revolutions per minute of the shafts, and the D is equal to external diameter of the shafts, and sometimes we may use this as DO, small DO, that is external diameter or outside diameter of the shaft in millimeters. And small d here in this case, that is internal diameter of the shaft in millimeters. But also we can use this instead of small d, di we are going to use. That means inside diameter or internal diameter. And T is equal to torque or twisting moment in kilonewton meters. Next is torsional stiffness. Generally, the definition for stiffness is load per unit deflection. Whereas now here in this case, torque per unit torsional deflection. So it is the ratio. So the torsional stiffness can be defined as the amount of torque required to twist the shaft through 1 degree. The strength of the shaft is measured by the amount of torque it can transmit. And lateral rigidity, what is lateral? So far we have completed the torsion rigidity. And now what is lateral rigidity? Lateral means perpendicular to the axis of the shaft. The resistance against the lateral deflection or transverse deflection of the shaft under the action of external load. That means these loads are perpendicular to the axis of the shafts. So due to say this deflection takes place, lateral deflection takes place due to mountings like pulleys and gaze, etc. And also sometimes it may take due to weight of the shaft itself. So that will become lateral rigidity and lateral deflection. That means lateral deformation, lateral deflection. So the deflection of shaft under vertical loading. Effect of lateral deflection. As a result of large deflection, that is large lateral deflection, there will be an excess amount of wear on the bearings. And it must be within the permissible limit to maintain proper bearing clearance of gate teeth alignment. So sometimes due to the lateral deflection, the bearings may worn out and they may have to be completely replaced. That is the problem due to large deflection and due to overweight also. And due to also continuous running of the shafts, the bearings, that may also causes this lateral deflection due to the worn weight, due to the mounting weight. Sometimes the deflection, lateral deflection may be more due to the more or large amount of lateral deflection. The bearings may get worn out, thereby you have to replace the bearings. That is the problem. So the deflection of shaft for various types of loads may be computed by using the formula. So for lateral deflection, Y is equal to constant into W L cube by EI. And where Y is equal to lateral deflection, and the W is equal to load on the shaft in newtons. L is equal to supporting length of shaft in millimeters. And E is equal to modulus of velocity or its modulus in newton per millimeter square. And this constant depends on Y is equal to constant WLQ by EI. And WLQ by EI remains as such, but the constant varies depending on the type of loading and also type of beams. So that's why here you can see, so I is equal to moment of inertia in mm power of 4. So deflection of the shaft for various types of loads may be calculated by this general equation, y is equal to constant WLQ by EI, y is equal to lateral deflection, w is equal to load, vertical load, and l is equal to length of the shaft, e is equal to modulus of velocity or n's modulus, I is equal to moment of inertia. And this constant depends on the type of loading and also type of beam condition also depends. So the design of shaft based on lateral deflection. So here is the solid shaft and hollow shaft. The value of moment of inertia for solid shaft is equal to I is equal to moment of value for I for solid shaft, I is equal to pi b power of 4 by 64 for solid shaft, whereas for hollow shaft I is equal to pi capital D power of 4 minus small d power of 4 by 64. So here in this case capital D may be DO and small d may be DI. It means this is the outside diameter or external diameter of the shaft, and this is the inside diameter or internal diameter of the shafts. So m is the moment of inertia in millimeter power of 4, where d is equal to external diameter, also equal to DO, outside diameter or external diameter, and small d is the internal diameter, or also sometimes this is DI, inside diameter. So with this, I can be calculated for solid shaft as well as the hollow shafts. So constant y depends on the manner of load distribution and supporting conditions. As I told you already, y, this constant of y depends on the manner of load distribution. That means it may be point load at the center of the shaft, or it may be different loads at different parts of the shaft. Also conditions may be, it may be simply supported on two bearings on two ends, or it may also be cantilever type. That means one is, the shaft is overhung and the load will be at the one side. So that means just like a cantilever beam. That means supporting conditions may be simply supported type or cantilever type, and load distribution may be self weight of the shaft or sometimes weight of the mountings at the center of the shaft or some various points of the shaft. Sometimes at one place that may be the pulley and one place that may be the gear also. So that means load distribution as well as supporting conditions decides the constant, right, of this deflection formula. And for simply supported shaft which concentrated load at the mid span, the expression for deflection is simplified and will be equal to y is equal to WLQ by 48 EI. That means constant is equal to 1 by 48, where W is equal to load at its mid span, L is equal to length of the beam, L by 2 is equal to half of the length, and another half is L by 2, and these are the supports of maybe bearings, of support of bearings. So this is just like a simply supported beam with a point load at its mid span. So in such conditions, the lateral deflection formula will be given as y is equal to WLQ by 48 EL. That means the constant is 1 by 48. For cantilever shaft, which is with the concentrated load at the free end, and the expression for deflection is simplified and will be equal to. So this is the like a cantilever beam, and one bearing is there here in this case, and it is running through the bearing to the overhanging length L, and a point load that may be the pulley or that may be the gear also sometimes, and this may be the point load W. For this, the formula, lateral deflection formula, will be Y is equal to WLP by EI, that means by 3. 1 by 3 into WLP by EI. That is 1 by 3 is the constant. If the shaft is just like a cantilever beam with a concentrated load at its 3N. So this formula also we must remember. So Y is equal to WLQ by 3EI. And the limiting values of lateral deflection and also sometimes torsional deflection. So angular twist is limited to 1 degree in a length of equal to 20 times of its diameter of shaft. The limiting values for torsional deflection or angular twist is only 1 degree. When the length is of the shaft is equal to 20 times the, that means L is equal to 20D, where D is the diameter of the shaft. And in practice, the deflection is limited to 0.84 mm per meter length of the shaft. The first one is the torsional deflection, that is theta or angular twist also, that is only 1 degree when the length is equal to 20 d, and this is the second one is the lateral deflection, it is only limited to 0.84 mm per meter length of the shaft. So with this limiting values, that means if the torsional deflection or lateral deflection exceeds their limiting values, sometimes the shaft may be failed or may take fractures. So that should be avoided. Thereby, these are the limits for the both deflection, that means torsional deflection as well as the lateral deflection. So right, so now let us see some of the problems. So far we have discussed about the torsional rigidity, torsional stiffness, and then lateral rigidity for both the hollow shafts as well as the solid shafts. And also we have completed limiting values of lateral deflection or angular twist, and also limiting values for lateral deflection. Previously is the torsional deflection, and now it is the lateral deflection. So these are the limiting values. Now let us see some of the problems based on the rigidity, design of shafts on the basis of rigidity. See, so the problem one, here you can see a mild steel shaft transmitting power is subjected to a torque of 2860 newton meters, that means 2860 newton meters, that is the torque transmitted by the, that means mild steel shafts, and the angle of twist is 1 degree, and theta is equal to 1 degree in a length of 1498 mm. So length of the shaft is given to you, angle of twist is also given, theta is also given to you, torque T is also given to you, and the modulus of rigidity is 0.79 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per millimeter square, that is G also given to you, G or C or N, whatever it is. Calculate the diameter of the shaft in millimeters. So the given data is number one, torque, and number two, angle of twist, and number three, length of the shaft, number four, torsional, modulus of rigidity, with this data you have to calculate diameter of the shaft. So already we are having the formula theta is equal to TL by GJ. So the relevant formula is P by J G theta by L, and where except J value, all other data are known to you. T is also there for us, G is also there for us, theta in degrees is there, we have to convert this into radians, and the L is also there. So only unknown parameter is J, which is the polar moment of inertia. So after finding the J value, you can calculate your diameter of the shafts. So J is equal to TL by G theta. So T is there for us. So 2860 Newton meters, that is to be converted into millimeters, thereby 28.6 into 10 to the power of 5. And the length is also known for us, 1498 mm, and also modulus of rigidity is also there for us, that is 0.79 into 10 to the power of 5, and also angle of twist in degrees is there, that we have to convert into radians, that is 1 into pi by 180. This should be the pi. So after substitution of all T, L and G theta, we are going to get J value in millimeter power of 4. That is, J is equal to 30,98,936.7, which is equal to pi by 32 d power to the 4. For solid shafts, J is equal to pi d power to the 4 by 32, and d is equal to this, not d power to the 4, only d is equal to 4th root of 32 J by pi. And after substitution of our J value, you will get D value. That means diameter of the solid circular shafts. So that is D is equal to 75 mm. So this is the formula. This is the procedure to calculate the diameter of the shaft when this design is based on the rigidity. This design is based on the rigidity. That means based on rigidity, D is equal to 75 mm. And now, second problem. The hollow shaft with the diameter ratio, which is the hollow shaft, previously is the solid shaft. Now it is the hollow shaft 3:5. That means 3 by 5 is equal to K is equal to 3 by 5 is equal to DI by DO or small d by capital D, is required to transmit a torque of, here the torque is given to you, 35,820 Newton meters. The shearing stress in the shaft must not exceed, that means permissible value of shear stress is equal to 60 Newton per millimeter square, and the twist over a length of 3 meters, that means length of the shaft is 3 meters, must not exceed 1 degree. So twist theta is equal to 1 degree. Calculate the size of the shaft satisfying these conditions. Take G is equal to 80 giganewtons per meter square. So here in this case, we are having the torque, we are having the permissible shear stress, and we are having the length of the shaft, and also we are having the theta value, and also we are having the G value. That means modulus of rigidity. So when observing this, the given data, we had to determine the diameter of the shafts, that means outside diameter as well as inside diameter, based on both strength, that means the design is based on the strength as well as the design is based on the rigidity also. So after calculation of diameters based on rigidity as well as the strength, whichever is the larger value, that we have to take into account. So that will be the answer for this problem. So let us see the solution. First of all, let us have the solution given that d is to d is equal to 3/3:5. That is, d small d by capital D is equal to k is equal to 3/5, and the t is equal to 35,820 newton meters. That is, that 358.2 × 10⁵ newton millimeters. And Fs, shear stress, permissible shear stress, or allowable shear stress is 60 newton per millimeter square, whereas the theta is equal to 1 degree per 3 meters of length of shaft. So g is equal to 80 giganewton per meter square, and that should be equal to 80 × 10�³ newton per mm square. That means, so 0.8 × 10⁵. So find the size of the shaft, and also that means sizes of the design, the shaft size of the shaft, and also small d as well as capital D. You have to calculate with this problem. So design of shaft, first let us say take design of the shaft on the basis of strength. So small d by capital D is equal to 3/5, which is also equal to k, where d is equal to 0.6 d, and k is equal to 0.6. so equation for torque, equation t is equal to 5/16 Fs, capital D power to the 4 minus small d power to the 4/d. So we are having the value of Fs and also T, and the ratio is also there. Small d is equal to 0.6 d. If you substitute instead of small d 0.6 d, then you will get capital D. So 5/16 Fs d³, capital D cube into 1 minus k^4, where k is equal to 0.6, then you are going to get your substituting the values. We get d value is equal to capital D. That means outside diameter or external diameter is equal to 151.731. So this is the outside diameter or external diameter. With this, by substituting in the diameter ratio, k is equal to 0.6, that is small d by capital D, we can get internal diameter or inside diameter also. So small d is equal to internal diameter or inside diameter is equal to 0.6 d, is equal to 91.03878 mm. So this you can round off to the next higher values. So as per the standards, for the diameters above 140 mm, that you have to take 20 mm increment. That means, so it is should be 1.18. So this is 92. Now considering the torsional rigidity, so previously we solved, we determined the diameters based on strength. Now let us determine the diameters outside as well as inside diameters based on torsional rigidity. That is, T/J is equal to g(θ/L), where T is also known for us, and G is also known to us, and theta in radians, we have to convert this. And L is equal to length of the shaft is 3 meters and theta is equal to 1 degree. This we have to convert. So only unknown is J value, that is polar moment of inertia. From that polar moment of inertia, you are going to get your outside as well as inside diameters. So J is equal to TL/g(θ). So T is equal to this much value. 358.2 × 10⁵ into L is equal to 3 meters, so that is 3000 mm, and G is equal also known to you, 0.8 × 10⁵, and theta is equal to 1 degree, that is to be converted into radians. So finally, after substitution of all the values, you got J is equal to this much value, which is 7,69,62,556 mm^2, which is equal to pi by 32 capital D power to the 4 minus small d power to the 4, where the diameter ratio is also known for as 0.6 K1. Also, we know that J is equal to pi by 32 d power to the 4 minus small d power to the 4, and the J is also known to us. And if you bring back, it means take common factor as d, then d power to the 4 into 1 minus k power to the 4, k is 0.6, and only unknown is outside diameter or external diameter of the hollow shell. So with this substitution, we are going to get your outside diameter as 173.2368. So, and next is by substituting capital D in diameter ratio, then you are going to get inside diameter or internal diameter of the shaft as 103.942. When comparing to the diameters obtained by design on the basis of strength as well as the design on the basis of rigidity, the higher values are obtained by you when we have designed on the basis of rigidity only, that is 173.2368. So let us add up the diameters of hollow shaft when the design is based on the rigidity only. So considering the strength and rigidity, the large diameter is to be considered as a failure. If you take smaller values, that may fail due to rigidity. So that's why if you take the smaller values, then it can withstand the strength. But that means whenever there is a problem with different loads, then it may not fail. But whereas there is based on rigidity, it may fail. That's why the larger values are to be taken into account for designing purpose. So therefore, the design values are capital D is equal to 173.2368. That may be you can take it as 175. And this small d is equal to 103. That may you may take also 105. So this is the problem based on both rigidity as well as strength, and also it is the problem on basis of on hollow shafts. So next problem here, you can see the third problem. Calculate the diameter of the overhead line shaft. Overhead line shaft for the following particulars. Here the power transmitted is equal to 24 kilowatts. And the ratio of belt tensions is equal to 2, that is T1 by T2. Belt tensions is equal to, ratio of belt tensions is equal to tension on tight side by tension on slack side. That is T1 is the tension on tight side and T2 will be the tension on slack side. So T1 by T2 is equal to 2, and permissible shear stress is equal to 12 Newton per millimeter square. This may be the FS or tau value. And permissible deflection, 2 mm per meter of meter length, that means delta, or would say it may be the y is equal to 2 mm per meter of length. And also the shaft is supported at one end and is 1 meter long. That means shaft length is also given to you, and it is supported at one end. That means it is just like a cantilever shaft, cantilever beam. So that's why y is equal to WLQ by 3EI. Formula will be applicable for this equation, for this problem. And G is equal to 0.8 × 10⁵ Newton per millimeter square for shaft material. Here is the torque is given to you, ratio of belt tensions is also given to you, permissible shear stress is also given to you, permissible deflection is also given to you, and the shaft is just like a cantilever beam, and length is also given to you, and G is also given to you. So here also you have to calculate based on lateral deflection and also strength point of view. So first of all, let us calculate based on strength point of view, that you will get the torque value, and the torque is equal to net tension into radius of the shaft. You can see. So let us see the solution for this problem. The shaft supported at one end, that is, so P is equal to 24 kilowatts, that is 24,000 watts, and the N is equal to 180 revolutions per minute. DP is equal to diameter of the pulley is given to you, 1.2 meter, that is 1200 mm. So the ratio of belt tensions T1 by T2 is equal to ratio of tensions is equal to 2, and Fs is equal to permissible shear stress 12 newton per mm square. So the given data, theta is equal to permissible twist, or say it may be the lateral deflection 0.5 degrees per meter length. And lateral deflection, permissible deflection is equal to 2 mm per meter length. So here in this problem, actually the problem is not completely defined. The problem is not completely defined because theta is not there in the problem, as well as the diameter of the pulley is also not given to us. But here in the given data, they have incorporated. That's why that is absolutely wrong. But let us say take theta in the problem itself as the 0.5 degrees, and also you have to take diameter of the pulley as 1.2. meters. So L is also given to length of the shaft 1 meters, that is 1000 mm, and the G is also given as 0.8 × 10⁵ newton per mm square, and E is also known to us. This is also not given in the problem itself, so this also have to be taken in the problem. That means the problem is not completely defined. So that's why if you incorporate all these values, theta as well as E, and also diameter of the pulley, then it will become very easy for us. So with this given data, you have to design based on the basis of strength. Number one, you have to design on the basis of torsional deflection, and also that means torsional rigidity, and also you have to design on the basis of lateral rigidity. So after calculating all the values, you can take the larger value into account. Find the diameter of the shaft. So power in belt transmission, P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. This formula is to be remembered in this, because here it is not there. Or otherwise, torque is equal to T1 minus T2 into R, radius of the pulley. So V is equal to velocity of the belt, V is equal to pi dp, n by 60, that is, and V is equal to 11.309734 meters per second, and T1 by T2 is also known for us. So T1 is equal to 2T2. Let us substitute this value in this power equation, then you will get T1 and T2. T2 is equal to 2122.0658 newtons, and T1 is equal to 4244.1318 newtons. So T1 and T2 is known for us in this, and lateral rigidity, and here in this it is just like a cantilever, and that's why WLP by 3EI. And where W is equal to total load of the weight of the pulley, as well as the total tensions acting on the pulley on the shafts, and also if possible we should also take the self weight of the pulley. But here we are neglecting the self weight of the pulley, and also there is no weight of the pulley itself, so self weight of the shaft, and also there is no weight of the pulley, that only the available load acting on the pulley, on the shaft at its free end is total load by belt tension only, that is W is equal to T1 plus T2. That we have to take into account. So T1 is known for us, T2 is also known for us, this 6,366.1977 newtons. So I is there for us, I is equal to pi by 64 d power to the 4. So only you have to calculate d value, that means W is there for us, L is also there for us, N minus is also there for us, and also delta or Y is also known for us, Y is also given to you, there you have to calculate I value. So after substituting directly the I value, D is equal to 101.96 millimeters. Considering the tie so far, we have completed the problem based on lateral rigidity. Now let us calculate based on consider the torsional rigidity. T by J, G theta by L. G is also known for us, theta is also known for us, L is also known for us, T is also known. We can calculate T also and J also. From the J you are going to get diameter of the shaft. And T can be calculated by T is equal to T1 minus T2 into radius of the pulley. So torque is equal to T1 minus So this is wrong. Solution in this problem is wrong. So this is T1 minus T2 into R, capital R, that is 0.6 it will come. So the value is changes, value changes in this. T is not correct in this. So J, you can calculate it. The procedure is only here it is wrong. So D is equal to, so you will get 74.59 millimeters. So based on torsional rigidity, 74.59 millimeters, and also lateral rigidity 101.96, and also we have to calculate also based on strength, but here not shown. That is absolutely wrong. So whichever is the larger value, that you have to take into account. So you have to, in this problem, actually the problem itself is defined and not defined properly. But number one, in that problem you have shear stress also, and you have theta also, you have y also, and you have e also, you have G also, and you have FS also. So by seeing all this data, you have to design the shaft based on both strength basis and lateral rigidity basis and torsional rigidity basis. After calculating this, you can determine whichever is larger value. So right, this is all about the today's the design on the basis of rigidity. So let us have the summary of this lesson. In this lesson, we have discussed the design of shafts on the basis of torsional rigidity and lateral rigidity for the solid and hollow shafts, and limiting values for angular twist and lateral deflection. And let us have a small quiz. For this, limiting value theta for the torsional rigidity of the shafts, 0.84 mm per meter length of the shafts, 1 degree in a length of 20 times its diameter, and 0.1 degree in a length of 20 times its diameter, and the answer A and B is also right answer. Now, as per our discussion so far, so B is the right answer, 1 degree in a length of 20 times its diameter. So B is the right answer. Let us have another limiting value of lateral deflection. reflection perpendicular to VT of the shaft is simply we are having 0.84 mm per meter length of the shaft. So A is the right answer. Here you can see the two shafts A and B are made of same material. Both the shafts are made out of same material. The diameter of the shaft A is twice as that of the shaft B. The power transmitted by the shaft A will be dash of the shaft B. 2 times, 4 times, 8 times, and also 16 times, which is the right answer. Eight times is the right answer. The shaft, two shafts will have equal strength if the diameter of both the shafts is same, angular twist for both the shafts is same, the material of both the shafts is same, twisting moment of both the shafts is same, twisting moment, if the twisting moment of both the shafts is same, then the strength will be same. So with this we conclude the lesson.